It is the Monday after the LA Fit Expo. It is 2:30. I spent the entire morning working, right? This is like a funny story. So, get back from the expo yesterday. You guys saw that I went from the expo to the Pardoma's workshop. I had my car at the hotel and I like left it there. I was like looking for my keys everywhere. I was like, where are my keys? I must have put them in my bag or something. They're with the valet at the hotel. So I came all the way home, not even thinking about my car. So Karen's gonna get me a ride to the gym. We're getting ready to go to the gym.
We're like, where's your keys, Amanda?
Sometimes I have no brain cells after spending an entire weekend at the expo. It was a busy weekend. Do I have an excuse? No, I don't. I am just stupid sometimes. I don't have any excuses.
Second time you put the stevia in the microwave.
Sometimes I do stupid stuff like put condiments in the microwave instead of the cabinet. And leave my car at hotels across the city. Good stuff. I'll get my car later, but I do have to lift now. Yeah, fun stuff. We have a fun workout plan today also. So it's been a very long weekend and today is probably my hardest day of lifting for the whole week. I'm gonna show you guys everything I do once I get to the gym, but yeah. Let's get the day started, guys. Start on a good note. Of my one rep max, squat, bench, and deadlift, and we're doing 5 sets of 2. So it's gonna be a grinding day today. I have to really focus on warming up because I was standing all weekend long at the expo, and it doesn't seem like it's that bad, but when you're standing all weekend long and you're just like shifting your weight from left to right and don't really have too much time to like stretch out, and I did not exercise all weekend. I didn't foam roll. I was just so busy. So my body's really tight. I need to make it loosey-goosey. Zoning out everything else that's going on today. Got my blinders on. It's just me and you guys. It's me and the barbell, and that's it today.
So thank you to my angels and the man that's up above. And my only competition, that artist that wore a glove. I'm chasing legends, so I guess I'm chasing heaven. I'm placing bets and breaking odds and rolling lucky sevens. Shit, I'm celebrating life, so pour a glass and have a cheers. Till I'm gone, I know my paradise is here. Yeah.
Sped up the camera like 8 times the normal speed, and that took me like 10 minutes to get those on, but I swear to God, it's worth it. If you're gaining strength and you're getting really heavy, then these are absolutely worth it. But otherwise, you can just get the lighter, thinner version of these. I'll put the links in the description box for you guys. It's the week of friends.
Friends!
People decide to stay in LA a little bit after the expo because it's fun. Randy like lives here.
I'm going back on February 31st, which is never, because it doesn't exist.
Oh, I was like, wait, I don't get it.
So we are finishing our last set of squats. I've been here for an hour and a half. Moving on to bench and deadlift after this. It has become my thing to eat half of this pre and half of this intra workout for my training days, because I have training days 3 days a week up until the meet. I think I have 5 or 6 training sessions left before the meet. So I gotta fuel up, you know? This is good. I raise my hand to the fire, but it's no use, 'cause you can't stop it from shining through. It's true, baby, let the light shine through. If you believe it's true, baby, won't you let the light shine through for you. It's 5:30 p.m. I got here at 2:30 p.m. I am completely drained. Long day at the expo. I know this is going to be like a mental workout, but 3 more sets of deadlifts at this weight. I just failed at this for no reason. Powerlifting workouts are very, very mental. Pushing through the long, long lifts, although it's similar to bodybuilding workouts where you're at the end of your prep. Things are really difficult. You have to push through mentally, you have to be strong mentally. And it's like so close to just like walk out and be like, you know what, I've been here for 3 hours, it's good enough. But at the end of the day, I'm competing for a purpose, and if I don't execute my workouts, then I'm not gonna be able to execute on meet day, you know what I mean? So it's one of those things where you just have to like finish regardless of how crappy you feel. These deadlifts aren't going the way that I would like them to. I'm going to finish them with 110% my best, because I feel like crap. I'm like so worn down. 35:30. I have so much stuff to do tonight, but I can't think about that right now. I have to stay focused on this and doing this the best I can, because this is what I committed to, and this is what is going to me doing the work right now is what's going to get me the end result that I want. So at the end of the day, work regardless of whether or not you're tiring, whether or not it's really inconvenient, whether or not it feels like crap, whether or not you're tired. You just have to put in the work and then you'll get what you want. Does that make sense? Hope so. Guys, we just finished the lift. Took me 3.5 hours. I've been here for forever, and I'm definitely physically and mentally drained, but this is my last week of heavy lifts. I have 4 or 5 more lifts before the meet, so it's okay that these lifts are long. I'm literally lifting 3 days a week, every other day off, and these lifts are just really, really long, so I need the recovery time, but I also need to put in the work, and I'm glad that I pushed through. This is some sort of like different kind of mental thing, man. It's different from bodybuilding for sure, but you require the same type of self-discipline to finish. So we did it, we finished, we're done. You finish your workout now. If you're watching this on cardio, you finish. I am Ubering home from the gym because I don't have a car. All right, post-workout meal is gonna be bite meals, chicken, broccoli. Oh, where is it? Chicken, broccoli, and red potatoes. Hello. Hi. You're Amanda?
Amanda.
Yes,
how are you?
How are you? Yeah.
Okay.
got them? Okay, thank you.
Anytime.
Went all the way across the city, got the car, now I'm back home. All right, guys, this peanut butter is the best thing. I'm gonna finish this off. The only fat sources I had all day were this peanut butter. I like by accident didn't eat fats today and I was like, all I had was four tablespoons of nuts and more birthday cake peanut butter.
That's how you do it.
Who's that voice in the background? Can you guys guess who it is? You already know.
What up?
Irish people. Hello, these are my roommates for the weekend. We're all having like a little work party right now, like they're on their computers.
I literally feel like so at home here. It's the only house I can go in.
Well, you made yourself at home. Yeah, I'm just kidding.
Whip out my laptop and be like, yeah, okay, see you in a couple of hours.
Yeah, see you in a couple of hours. Karen and I are in our usual spots, like
also eating
this
nut butter.
This is so normal. This is just normal life. I'm here watching videos, editing. You're editing, you're doing client emails, you're editing.
Yeah.
Either way. Anyway, so I'm gonna go ahead and cut this video off here. I will restart a new vlog tomorrow. And then Rob and Sarah are here for the week. So you guys will see them in the next couple videos. I'm gonna finish this off. I'll catch you guys in the next one.